simple curry recipe under 5 minutes. If you don't have the time and if you just have buttermilk or yogurt in the fridge, this can be just done under 5 minutes, and it's very simple, very delicious, irresistible, filled with flavors. That's what I'm bringing to you from my hometown to your table. So keep watching till the end for the important tips. It's very simple and easy, but it can be easily messed up if you don't follow the instructions. So let's get started. More curry undakkam. Welcome to Shine with Shoops. This channel is all about making you shine with my healthy diet and building your emotional strength. So make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any new updates from me. For this, I'm taking 2 cups of yogurt. It's even better if the yogurt is sour. You may use homemade or store-bought. Add 2 cups of water to it and beat the yogurt really well using a blender. This step is very important, and this is the consistency we are looking for. Now place a saucepan over medium heat. Add 1 teaspoon of coconut oil. Once heated, add 1 medium-sized onion cut in lengthwise. This is how I prefer. You may cut it into small pieces if you wish. Lengthwise cut onion helps to caramelize better. You can use shallot instead of onion. To this, I'm adding 1 inch of ginger thinly sliced. Add 2 green chilies slit lengthwise. Stir well until the onion are translucent. Moor curry is a delicacy in Kerala. You can prepare this with coconut or without coconut. My mother makes it without coconut and I love it this way. And a few curry leaves. Always stir the curry leaves for extra aroma and flavor. Love the smell. The word moru refers to buttermilk in Malayalam language. This is nothing but a seasoned buttermilk. Stir for a minute and add 1 teaspoon of salt and 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric. This will bring out the golden color in this curry. It also has plenty of health benefits. Continue to stir. If it sticks to the pan, add a bit of water to deglaze. These spices are the key ingredients for the flavor. These are very simple ingredients, but the magic happens when it's done the right way. Keep stirring until it's nice and golden brown. It's time to add in the yogurt. Give it a quick stir. One important thing to note here, we need to make sure the flame is very low and then add in the yogurt. At this point, do not keep the flame on high heat. It should be very, very low, and continuously stir in. Make sure that it's just hot and do not let it boil. This is very important. Do not let it boil, otherwise it will curdle. So just a couple of minutes continuously stirring so that all the ingredients are incorporated well. That's it. Transfer it to a serving bowl and we'll be tempering this dish. This technique enhances the flavor and increases nutritional value. This is a very important step. So for this, use another separate pan. Add 1 teaspoon of coconut oil. Coconut oil is essential to bring in the flavor. To this, add a few mustard seeds and let the mustard seed crackle. Once you hear the crackling sound, add in the dried red chili and more curry leaves. I can already smell this. This is wonderful. I like it a little spicy, so I'm going to add a little bit of red chili powder. Stir it, and now let the magic happen. Beautiful. This moor curry is filled with flavors. You can have it with rice. I'm going to have it with rice. And along with rice, I made pavikka curry, Kerala style. It's a bitter gourd vegetable with coconut, which I'll be uploading next. This moor curry is so delicious. Do give it a try. If you have to reheat it, never let it boil. Just a minute in microwave should do.
So you saw how simple this recipe can be. It can be made under 5 minutes. So if you enjoy this recipe, share it with your friends and stay tuned for that bitter gourd paveka curry. It's coming up. And don't forget to shine with Shobhs.